Children by nature believe in the unseen world because they've just come out of it. They're much closer to it than we are. Babies, according to Sidi Abd al-Aziz al-Dabbagh, are conversing with angels. So I think it's very easy for a child to be nurtured spiritually because they are essentially spiritual beings.
Imam al-Ghazali talks about the soul of the child as being a precious uncut jewel like a diamond. Since there needs to be a cutting, a disciplining, a refinement, not to suppress what it truly is, but to bring to the surface the luminosity that it's been brought with, that it's been born with, which is the heritage of all humanity, the recollection of the primordial covenant, which is what we are really about.
Siempre un mensaje sobre material, ¿no? De tecnología, de mucho pensar en esta vida de la dunia y no tener ninguna referencia, ninguna inquietud y ninguna puerta para abrir esas llaves del conocimiento. Y no es otra que el conocimiento de lo interno, que es lo más importante.
In terms of the entertaining captivatingness of what media and culture can be, nothing compares with Hollywood and the products of the capitalistic marketing system. And that's very dangerous and very entrancing. There's a kind of vertiginous power that it has over young people.
A couple of years ago, I did a little research project around the available Islamic studies curriculum programs, and I was really disappointed to see the variety of issues that are challenging us today in the curriculum department.
One of the things that I see in youth right now in this day and age, it's very easy to kill the love for knowledge.
How?
Because, well, I mean, curriculums that are unimaginative, programs that are not designed to help them think.
Education tends to be associated in the modern context with basically the imparting of information that will have utilitarian value in adult life. And increasingly today is divorced from morality, from cosmology, from metaphysics, from a deeper sense of human purpose and from contemplation.
Reconciling this split and this divide that we have between ta'lim and tarbiyah, that reconnecting the knowledge with the practice, reconnecting knowledge with character building, reconnecting, and that's what knowledge is.
To give the children a good tarbiyah from the beginning. To raise a child, you cannot just wait until the age of puberty and then you start correcting the child. It has to start at the beginning.
So education and tarbiyah are two very different things. Tarbiyah is about providing human beings with the maintenance of their innate goodness, which is from the fitrah and the day of Am I Not Your Lord? Primordial covenant.